Hi guys, my name is Ferdy, and in this video series I will show you how you can work with all the Elementor Pro elements. In this video we will take a look at the navigation menu element. If you want to get Elementor Pro, then click on the link below in the description. And if you buy Elementor Pro through my affiliate link, you don't pay more, but I get a commission, so thank you for that. If you want to see the result of all the Elementor Pro elements, then go to elementor2018.com and go to the page Elementor Pro. Here I will show you all the elements, so let's get started. Here I want to build all kinds of Elementor Pro elements, so I click on Edit with Elementor. And if I scroll down over here at the left, I see Pro elements, and all those Pro elements come with the Pro version. I want to start with the navigation element over here, so I add a new section. The structure will be only one area, and I drag this over here, and you'll see the menu immediately. If I would save it, Command S or Control S, and I close this, you see the result. You can hover over things, there's a submenu, it's our normal menu, and we can adjust it. So I turn this on again. We can select the menu over here, I have only one menu. We can change the layout. Now it's a horizontal menu. You can change it to vertical, then it will look like this. If you click. But you also can have a drop-down menu. And it looks like that. I want to use the horizontal menu. We can align it, so we can align it to the left, like it is right now, or to the right, or to the middle, or we can have it full width and stretch it like this. I like it at the left. And right now we are at the Elementor Pro page. And you see that because it's blue, you see an underline. Here at the pointer you can have overline, so the line will be above Elementor Pro, or framed. And there are a few different options you can choose. And when you hover over the other menu items, you see the same display. So if I say underline, and I hover over here, you also see underline. I like background. And if you hover over those, you see the background. I like it. You can have an animation. Right now the background fades. You can also can say grow, and then if you hover over it you see the background grow. Or sweep down. I like it. The submenu indicator. Here is a submenu, and if I hover over it I see photography, videography and web design, and it's an arrow down like that. You can change the arrow to chevron, angle, or plus. I like the angle. It looks nice. By Command S or Control S, you can save it. There are a few mobile settings. What is the breakpoint of a mobile menu? You can have a mobile menu for a tablet or for a mobile. I like it to be for a tablet also. So when you watch this page on a mobile or a tablet, it will become a burger menu like this. So when I drag it like this, it is a normal menu. And if I make it smaller, it becomes a menu like this. So let's change a few things and let's see how it looks on a mobile drop-down menu. Full width, right now, it's not full width, but if I would say full width, it looks like this. I like that. The alignment in the center looks like this. I rather have it at the left, so I say aside. And the toggle button, if I would say none, that means that the menu is always active. I don't like that, so I would say hamburger. And that is this icon. When I click on it, it opens. When I click again, it closes. We can align the hamburger to the right or to the left. I like it in the middle. So that's about mobile. What I like to do, I like to go over here to the columns. I like to duplicate this one, and I want to remove this menu. I drag this to the right. So here we have the menu, and here I want to place my logo of my website. I click over here. I search for an image. I drag it over here to the right. I choose an image. So I search for a logo. Here it is. I insert the media. I want this to be at the right, and I want this to be at the right as much as possible. So now it looks like this. I want to align this area to the bottom of the logo. How can I do that? I can search for a spacer. I drag it here above. Now it is way too low. So I decrease it to 10. Make this one a little bit bigger. Like that. But if I take a look at the mobile right now, it looks like that. I don't want that. So I click over here and I put it in the center. I save it. And now it looks like this. When I want the logo to be at the top and the menu at the bottom, but at the full screen, I want the menu to be at the left and the logo at the right, then I can go to the settings of the section. I go to advanced. I scroll down, I go to responsive, and I say reverse columns. And now it is reversed like that. I really like it. I go to the navigation menu again, to the style, and we can change the style of the normal menu item, like this one. I can change the text to a different color. I can change the typography, I can make it bigger or smaller. Change the font family, make it bold or default. I can transform it to uppercase, like that. Then make it a little bit smaller. Change letter spacing. We can change so much things. It is amazing. We can change the border of the active item. We can adjust the drop down. And the toggle button, which is the hamburger button on the phone. You can change the color. You can do so much things with this. And if we go back to the main menu, we go to hover. That's when you hover over it. You can change the pointer color to a green color or to a different color. So there are a lot of things you can do. And when you do that and you hover over here, you see the same color. And you can go to the active one and also change the color to this one, and then when you hover, you still see a different color. So you can style the menu a lot of different ways. Then we can go to advanced, change the padding and margin, and you can play around with those settings if you want to. You can have an animation, but I see no reason to create an animation in the menu. But if you want to do that, you can do that. You can turn this off for a tablet. Or you can hide it for the desktop, or a tablet, or a mobile phone, or only for smartphones and tablets. So that's it. If we take a look, we have our own menu. I want to take it a step further. Therefore, I want to remove this top bar. I want to create a section below that. This one. I click over here to the section settings. I want to stretch the section. I want it to be full width. The height. Minimum height of 400. And I go to the style, to the background. I grab an image, which is this one. And I want to go to the position, size, cover, background overlay. I want to go for gradient. And I want to place this color on top. I go back. I want to create a heading. I drag it over here. Go to style. Make it white color. Make it a bit bigger. I go to content. I want this to be in the middle. Something like that. I save it. Okay, what I want to do now, I want to bring this area below the menu. So I hover over the element, I go to advanced, I do the arrow down, so I go to the minus, and I want to have minus 110. But what you will see, you see the menu in front of this background, but the background is not behind this image. So I click on this image, I go to advanced, and over here at Z index, I do plus one, and that will solve it. It's a little bit weird. I cannot go to this icon again. So what I need to do, I click over here. I go to advanced and for a temporal time, I do this. This one, I bring to minus 110. And then I go to this one again and bring this back to zero. Like that. Let's take a look. Okay. I want to select the menu, go to style, change the color to white, like that. And for the active color, I go to content, to the pointer, and I say framed. And actually, I want this to be white also. So I go to style, hover, pointer color, white, like that. And when I hover over something, it looks like that. I like it. What I want to do now, I want to remove this logo or change it. So I click over here, delete, and I want to upload the white one because it looks better. Then we need to have a little workaround. I don't know how you call that in English, but we need to do a trick. I need to select this area, but it will not work because of the margin and the padding. I click over here and I want to increase the minimum height to something like that, so it has a little bit more space. And now we've created our own menu. And that's how you make a custom logo within Elementor Pro with a lot of different options. I want to know how this looks on a tablet. So I go to style. And over here, it looks fine. If I close this, you see, I want this word to go to the next line, so I make it a little bit bigger. Like that. When I take a look at a tablet, it looks like that, so I want to make it smaller. Like that, and on the smartphone, like that. Save it, go back to a desktop. I refresh the page. This is the desktop screen. If I make it smaller, it changes to this, and it becomes even smaller. It looks like that. I don't want this, of course. How can I fix that? I go to the tablet. There it goes. So what I want to do now, I want to click over here. Go to Z index, say 1. Okay. Now it's in front of the background. Then I go, for now I say padding 100. So I can select this. And I say minus 50. I unlink it. And then I go over here again. I say 0. I want to have this one. And now I say, go like that. Okay. I go to the desktop. I go to the menu, to style. I scroll down. I go to the toggle button. And I want to change it to white. Now if I make the screen smaller, it is white, like that. When I make it even smaller, then I should bring this up again. How can I do that? I go over here to the section settings, advanced. I go to the smartphone. I go down. I uncheck it. So this one is 0. And I bring this up again. Until I think it fits perfectly. Then I go over here to this one, to the padding of the smartphone. I uncheck it and I bring this up. And it can look a little bit complicated, but when you've done it, it looks amazing. So I refresh it. This is how it looks on a desktop, and this is how it looks on a mobile. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please like this video, subscribe if you want to have more videos, and then I will see you next time. I wish you the best. Bye bye.